Hello everyone and welcome back to another Let's Play Total War Warhammer here on Prime and Go. So, today I'm going to be restarting my Vampire Counts Let's Play. I'm going to be going on the same difficulty, which is a legendary. And my reason for this is with the new Grim and the Grave DLC, I can't actually gain access to any of the Ghoul Kings or anything like that on my current playthrough. And obviously I do want to play with Vlad Von Carstein, Hermann Gorst, obviously all the new renowned stuff and everything. I want access to everything. So I'm going to restart, and I'm going to restart as Vladimir Von Carstein. And yeah, so let's get started, and everyone has seen that intro by now, so no need to watch it again. So yeah, as I mentioned, I did actually quickly check my current playthrough and everything and find out that I couldn't actually gain access to anything. And at first thought it was a bug, so then I thought, you know what, I'll try a basic one.
Oh, Castle Drakenhof is returned to you, Vlad, first of the Von Carstein line. Yet despite your ancient and revered power, there are those who would see you undone and your bloodline erased. The Tempelhof brood control the lands to the north as far as the River Stir. They defy your hegemony as the first and greatest of the vampire counts. Raise the undead hosts, take their lands, and burn their crypts for this insolence. The high mountains to the south are infested with dwarfs. Your homelands will never be safe with such an enemy so close. Make plans to drive their stunted kind out. Greatness runs throughout the Von Carstein bloodline, my lord. Your greatness. You are the master of Sylvania, of all unliving, and soon, the world.
I do love the way you said that.
Soon, the world.
I do like the differences between Vlad Von Carstein and Manfred Von Carstein as well. You can tell that Manfred is more of a, shall we say, weaker hero, whereas this guy is like, you are the best, you are the god, and all the rest of it, whereas Manfred is kind of, yeah. So, as I was saying, I did a quick playthrough, a quick look on my other playthrough, and noticed that I couldn't actually gain access to any of the heroes, so the legendary lords and the cover chat, the Ghoul Kings, it would just pretty much wouldn't let me gain access to them. So then I quickly made start at number one and noticed that I could actually gain access to everything after that. So yeah, I thought, why not restart? We're only on turn 60, and yeah, we can actually do some pretty cool stuff where we're actually at it. Like for example, we can use the Ghoul Kings and make Ghoul King specific armies, like just the Ghoul King and loads of ghouls and crypt horrors and Vargeists and stuff like that. Or Vargulfs, sorry. So that'd be kind of cool. And yeah, so we've just killed that army.
He's there. Lord of the Night. No. I refuse.
I don't think I could actually take that on. No, not with this. So what I will obviously spend my points. I want that and that.
And Champion we'll go over of there. The Dark.
And over here we've got everything else on the way. We'll move on to that. There we go. Turn. Let it blitz all the way through. Okay, are you gonna attack me? No. Okay. Oh, there's a new lord there. Did I kill the last one then? I must have killed the last lord because now it's a Ghoul King. Now that he's actually left that, could I actually take it?
Bow before me!
Could I? Another load of scallies. Could I actually take that? Hmm. No, I don't think I will. I think I'll just take out
Vlad
and secure Eastern Sylvania first. What? What happened? What was all that about?
I am Vlad.
There we go. What's going on here? There we go. Okay, just a little bit of bug. So we got some zombies, some skellies, some bats, some dire wolves, some more skellies and zombies. And we have massive advantage. We'll play this because I don't want to try and I don't want to be auto-resolving all the time. That's one thing that I want to change from the last Let's Play, is I want actually more battles in this because it's more enjoyable for me, and I'm pretty much sure it's more enjoyable for you guys to watch as well. Well, now that I've got an even more better understanding of how certain units work and everything. And one thing I do love about Manfred is... Not Manfred, sorry, is Vlad. It's the fact that we can deploy pretty much in their face turn one. So dogs normally end up over there, so we'll put them there. We'll put the Blood Knights over there. These two guys in the center along with my leader and start battle. Grab everything and push.
Come at me, if you dare.
Speed it up. A little bit closer. God damn it, I hate it when he does that. Okay, we need to get Blood Knights, but not too fast. Oh, he's done it again. I hate it so much. Here we go, we're on the move. So what we got then, doggies on the flank as per freaking usual. Zombies are coming in. Throw them over there.
No one can stop.
Throw that up. We'll throw those in the center as well to help out. Put those a bit closer. Where did those dogs go? Throw them over to the side. Dogs are going a long way about, aren't they not? They've just charged in. That was stupid of them. Get those in the middle there. Blood Knights. Throw those into the back. Get some zombies into there. And our raiders are getting stuck in. Get them in there. How my spear's doing. I don't know why the spears are losing to dogs. I mean, I'd have thought it should have been a pretty much auto win. That's all I do. Yeah, get in on him for me. I'm going to heal there as well.
Darkness.
Throw them in back. Blood Knights, just pull you out again. We've got a nice little cluster in the center that we'll throw these guys into. Charge! Straight through. Can you keep coming? Can you keep coming all the way through?
Vlad Von Carstein! Death and destruction!
Come on, Blood Knights, keep coming through. Come on, you can make it all the way. Come on, buddies. All the way. Fargulf. Frid and left. Keep getting these Blood Knights out. You guys, move onto that flank for me. Take Fargulf with you to try and save that unit. We've only got one more to break out, and then we've actually got these all the way out, which would be nice. Feeble. Either break out or die. Make your choice. Thank you. Go. They're gonna mop that up nice and handily. Yeah. at the center. Just throw it again. Blood Knights are gonna absolutely decimate that side now. That Lord is dead, he's not gonna get out of that pile before he dies. He's fighting for his life. There he goes, he gets bashed by that skeleton there. He's the hero of that unit, and that is a GG. Thank you, no re. I do love how powerful Vlad is, 53 kills. He's such a tank, it's unreal. Well, skeletons didn't actually do bad, 24, 33, 31, 33. Zombies didn't do too bad either. Blood Knights always do well. Those dogs, they managed to do 46 kills to the blooming spears, and the spears were chilling still. What the actual hell? Are the spears not that good or something? That's a lot. I wasn't moving. I didn't tell them to move and like counter-attack or anything like that, so... There we go, level 3. We got the extra... Units of Renown, yeah, we got some Renown zombies. Oh, and some skeletons.
The taint of undeath is spread by your
conquest,
mighty
lord. We know about the taint of undeath, everyone hates it. Yeah,
your
go
realm
away.
Grows.
Thank you. Now tell me about the quest battle while you're at it.
Reports are coming in of a living expeditionary force close.
Thank you. Alright, now let me play the game. So, over here we want the brazier, and here we want to upgrade that. We will hold Eshin for now. Can we build a lord? Dark Acolyte? No, we don't want that. Military heritage? No. Someone? No. Shoot, no. What about Gold Kings? Campaign line of sight and intelligent. Plus 5% chance of wounding the aggressors. We're not going to need that for quite a long time. So, not too fussed about that particular one. We could go with campaign line of sight, I suppose. Is there any difference in stats on these guys? I'd love how much damage they do. Look at that. Weapon strength, 410. Compare... Oh, vampires. Okay, so 300. So he's basically somewhere in the middle. Melee attack. Alright, so he's not as powerful as I thought he was. Okay. I actually, first when I sort of looked at this, I was like, what the hell? 440, or 410, sorry. But no, he's just, yeah. Regeneration, weaknesses to fire, okay. Disintegration causes severe damage to self. Oh, that's when it's shattered. Crumbling. Undead. Hide in the forest. Encourage. Cause of fear, resilience, and missile. Okay. We'll go with campaign line of sight. Yeah, let's go with campaign line of sight. That's got a wall on it. Wardenhof has got a wall. Okay. So let's get ourselves a we'll go with campaign line of sight.
From the tomb.
But how can he recruit those?
The Von Carstein.
He's got, well, he wants that. Recruit that. Does that take it away from him?
Look on me in despair.
Ah, it does. So the regiments of renown are for only... That's for your entire faction. Okay, cool. I thought that was like, for every time you got one of these guys leveled up, they unlocked something along here. But apparently not. And we can't really raise anything yet. If I throw... I can't really move him just yet. We've got two more turns. Can we do anything diplomatic?
Relations with foreign powers may be managed through diplomacy.
Give me a trade agreement.
Consider
you don't want a trade agreement. I'll kill you instead then. How about that?
Before accepting any agreement.
How's about I just kill you then, if you don't want to help me? I don't care, I'm going to kill Tempelhofer anyway. I'm actually quite tempted to like, circumvent them and take Fort, whatever that is. Mainly because then it will mean that I'll drop his income. I don't know if the...
Of light.
The computer really cares about stuff like that, but we'll go with the hunger next for more revenge. This guy's a boss. I want him to get to level 4, because when he gets to level 4, he gets a rank up trait, which basically means every turn his units are getting experience, and oh my days, is it useful. You just sat, like, for example, like I'm sat here, these would be like bronze 1 and bronze 2 by now, just by sat here. I mean, how cool is that?
Vlad von Carstein.
See, it's this one here. The Coven of Death. That is just fantastic. And then after... So I get Coven of Death next. Then I'll get Relentless Dead. No, then I'll get Cloud of Horror for the speed and the movement range. And then I'll get that for more campaign movement range as well. So I'll have 20% movement range on this guy. So he'll be able to track people down a little bit better, I hope. Bloodlust. Lord of Vampires, we need that as well. Some of the the stuff that these guys can get. If did I end a turn?
Coward.
Yeah, I did. If you have a look at this chap here, research rate's good. As you everyone knows, research rate's actually pretty decent. But his summon, like for example, all of you lords can summon, right? Manfred can summon skeletons. This guy can summon skeletons. But this chap summons Graveguard, and this chap summons summons ghouls. It's freaking fantastic. Details. If we go to skills, and then we'll just go to this one. So that he raises ghouls, and then he can actually awaken. Eat this guy. Sorry, the Hellman Ghouls raises Graveguards. And he can actually spawn a White King. It's like, what? So, I think this guy's going to be like leader of my skeleton hordes. This guy's going to be leader of my ghouls. I think that's the way I'm going to do it. Now, so he's going to be like a main ghoul guy with like Vargulfs and Terrorgeists and stuff like that in his force.
Welcome to my court.
Welcome to my court. For now, I'll just rack him up with some zombies. Just so he can be a bit useful, and we'll put him on force march. And we'll get him all the way over there. This guy can summon another load of skeletons, some more spears, and we shall attack.
Yes! Massacre them!
Massacre them! So... yeah, balance of power is like massive in our favour. We'll fight it anyway. Mainly because I want to get into the habit of fighting most of the battles now, so... Okay, so if we have a look, we've got these, ghouls here. And we've got a couple of zombies, some dogs, and... yeah, so we need to kill those. I think... if I just throw... Vlad Von Carstein in at him, he should just pretty much mince them all on his own. And Ghoul King's going to be down there, so he's not going to be able to help anytime soon. Frontline of zombies, just for meat shield. Pop those in center like that. And nice little line. Spears either flank, because we do have dogs to contend with. We'll pop the Blood Knights over there. These two in the center. And Vlad there. Start battle, there's his force, come at me, bruh. And then you. Start running, I really don't care about your forces. They're not going to be in this fight any time soon, so I need to just get used to the fact that I'm not going to be using them. And that actually, bloody hell. Actually doubt I'll be using the Ghoul King in this one. Time soon either. Are you gonna charge me? You know you want to. Here we go. Okay, so we got where the ghouls. Ghouls there, dogs in the flank. Come on, do your formation that I told you to do, please. Thank you. Okay, so need to keep an eye on those dogs.
Be fast. Swiftly.
We pull these guys around, so the zombies are in there. Let's get those in there. Vlad, into the center, please. Need to go back and have a look at those dogs in a sec. That's where the wolves are. Where are those dogs? Those dogs are still on that flank. Pull them over. Pull them down. Reform those. These two over the back, please. They're fighting there. Where is my wolf? Can you actually help? They're just going to loop all the way around, aren't they? Good night. Charge. You two guys. Charge. You into them. Over here, that's where the crit ghouls are. They're just going to like mince that up, aren't they? Yeah, they are. There's no way I'm going to fight them with that flank anytime soon. Good night. Let's pull them out. Let's throw it here, look. Around there, try and keep everything healthy in the center. Thinking we might actually be able to trap these and freaking kill them off. I hate these dogs. They can catch the Blood Knights so easily. Right, the Ghoul King's actually made it into that combat. That, Vlad, you get into them. Where's my Blood Knights? Pull them out. And we'll get them into the rear of these guys, because these are anti-large. Go, nice rear charge. You guys, into the back of those. They're going to fight and lose. If we send the Vargas over there, they can help. Try and send the bats as well to help. The dogs are getting a rear charge. These guys are absolutely amazing them. And then Vlad, can you do the same? Yes, you can. So we've literally just crushed that center there. Oh, we've won. Oh, okay, fair enough. That was, yeah, I was actually taking that quite seriously, and then all of a sudden we just won. Look at the kills on these guys, these are amazing, 71 kills, Jesus. What do we get, 18 on the special dudes, 51 on the Blood Knights, not too shabby. Yeah, it's average, so basically we just held out and then just killed like their main unit and that was it. Dead Raise again. Cool, nice bit of loot. Gained an arcane, what's it? You can go to there. You can jump into there. And we'll, you can't raise. Got 2 turns before we can do anything. I want to sack that off. And I do want to sack that off as well. Yeah, sack it off now. Got to do the capital thing, so we'll go with tax rate, and Vlad needs an upgrade, so we're going with that. There we go, so we've got Waldenhof and Eschen with some stacks in them. I must admit the Ghoul King isn't really the strongest.
Power comes to parley, demanding a change in your mutual relations. Consider their offer carefully.
So they want 100 to join the war against Tempelhof. Okay, I suppose. You go and deal with one of their stacks would be nice. You're not allowed to go and take any of their settlements, so I draw the line of that. That's mine to do. Oh, we're only on turn 4. I thought it was higher than that. So they might go and take on that. We've got a stack there. Just zombies, though, isn't it, really? Raid's dead. We're raising another load of zombies there to try and keep it safe. We're taking them out of that stance. Upgrade that. Can't get anything there yet, but we can build this there. And I believe that'll be it for this turn.
The world will drown in blood.
Where can he reach? You didn't show me.
Bow!
I can reach him there, so it stands to reason that he can reach me here. But then again, I do have a lot of movement range on this chap, don't I? I have the extra 10%.
I am ready.
So if we burn to turn here, going into turn 5, that will allow... The reason why I've sacked off that thing for the that building in Eshin. Sorry, I forgot its name. It's like cemetery? Is that it? Is it the cemetery? Yeah, the reason why I sacked it off anyway is because I want to build this particular one. Where is it? This, for now. I will change it over to being Castle Temple Hoff. Or Drakenhof, is it Draken? Yeah, Drakenhof. But for now, I just want to put it here. That way it will unlock these for me. And I can just change it over at a later date. Because as it stands at the moment, I want the brazier for the Vampire Corruption. I need that early, just actually start doing that. And then obviously, yeah, I need the gold mine. So, yeah. And then I'm going to go for that as soon as I have enough surplus, which is in 6 turns. So in 6 turns time, we'll be all good. Maybe I should have built that there and then the brazier after I upgraded. Oh well. The Vampiric Corruption is always good. So how are we looking on corruption anyway? 100%, so. No biggie. We'll wait another turn and then we'll do the quest battle. How about that? I mean, the quest battle shouldn't be too difficult. It's just a standard quest battle really, isn't it? The Ghoul King can't come out and attack me because he didn't really have the forces to do it unless he does like a mass recruit and gets a really powerful army.
Come,
yeah, as expected. He's begging for peace. You ain't having it, buddy. We want... Where did that stat come from? What? Where did that come from? Tons of zombies. We have nothing to deal with. The corpse carts and everything. Oh my god. So, Eshin's a boss. God damn it. Where did that massive stack come from? I literally just said. Oh, it's come from elsewhere. I don't believe it. I thought that was save you and you had And he's... Oh. So that set me back quite a bit. Still 6 turns for that. I don't want to spend that again. I can't believe that. You git. You absolute git.
What?
I don't believe it. You absolute douchebag. I mean, obviously that guy got killed, didn't he? So I can't get him back. Damn it. So it was mainly ghouls and zombies, wasn't it? I know you got that there. Well, anyway, I want to do the quest battle. So we have some more spears. And we'll go and do the quest battle. I can't believe that. I literally just thinking to myself that we've got that safe now, we can build up, but no. Oh my god. Hey look, this is what I mean about that ranking system. Look, we've got rank 1 on these guys already. We've got rank 3 bronze blood knights. Rank 2 Vargulfs. Any dialogue? No. So, it's only Manfred who gets dialogue in this place then, is it? Oh god, how do I change my camera angle? How do I pitch the camera? Oh, this is gonna be... I can't... How do you pitch your camera? Game guide. Where is it? Technology characters manual. Would it be manual? Game guide to all getting started. Battle. Game tips. No. Races, maps, buildings, technology characters. Nope. Spell browser. Chat. Help pages. Go for a game. How do I change? Page up, page down, is that it? No? Oh my god, this is gonna be... It's gonna be so difficult to do. I can't... I feel like I'm cranking my neck. Oh, what about if I do? Oh, I can't do that. Bird's eye thing. Okay, so can I make this go down somehow? Or am I gonna have to like... Oh my god. This is like... I feel like my neck is cricking. You know, like you... I can't... Oh my god. What is this camera? I don't know how I'm going to actually pull this off with a camera like this. What for the commentary lands? Oh, here we go. Options. Controls. Rotate up. V. Rotate down. C. Okay. Back. Retrieve that up. C. Oh, that's so much better. There we go. Oh, I was worried for a sec then. Why won't it play? What's going on here? Game paused. Well, unpause it then. Why are you paused? Why don't you play? What's going on here? Resume battle. Why? What is going on? Battle. Is there a key to unpause? Special ability, toggle root hole. Unit speed. Speed up, game UI controls. Toggle pause, P. Zoom game, P. No. Play. Play. Why? I'm gonna have to concede defeat because I can't actually do anything. Well, that's rubbish. What the bloody hell happened there? First my camera bugs out, so I can't actually do anything, and then also my game won't work. Crushing defeat. An absolute crushing defeat. But I keep my army. Bow! Which is good. So let's try again. Hopefully this time it will, you know, work. It'll be good. Well, anyway, what's he got in his army? Two swords, two halberdiers, his spears, guns, archers, horses. Those horses are gonna get wrecked by my spears. Those bats and varvels will kill their archers, and then it's just a case of mop up what's left with a meat shield. Right, so let's get rid of that. So there we go. That's how you do your camera. That's how you find your units. Let's pan round. That's it. There we go. Put those guys like that. Those guys in the middle. Swords behind as always. Like that. Their horses are on that flank, so we'll put our horses, our spears there, our horses and spears here. Give us blood. Blood knights. Pop them there. Like that. There we go, stop out. Right, so it's halberdiers at the back. I still not tempting the main bulk, are we? Get them in. Oh, the floodlight. All the way down there, goddammit. My bad. Can we actually get these guys closer? How the hell did the horses get there? Get them in. Move them round. Swords into that unit to stop the bindings from falling down. Weaken you and then kick your ass. How the hell's doing? And then we'll put a heal down as well just to give it even better strength.
I am busy.
Go on, have him. Have him. That should have took his arm off. That should have like severed his spine. Yeah, that definitely got him. Jesus. I should have come out his boat. I love how the Blood Knights are watching. Right, what's going on? Are we winning? Should probably like start fighting everywhere else, shouldn't I, rather than watching that. I think everyone else is going to start running now anyway, so. Blood Knights has made it to that.
Blood Knights!
Pull them back out again.
Don't give them an inch!
They're pretty much numbing them. Lance has come down. I'd love it if you could see her like... What the hell? See how far he flew? Oh, he got back up there, that don't count. Oh, that was menacing. Jesus, these Blood Knights are relentless. Oh, these guys are amazing. I don't know how he survived that with that lance to the head. I like how he's just waltzing through. Oh, carnage. Right. I do love watching the cavalry charges and seeing how much smashing and everything they do. 50 kills. Love it. 56 on the Vargulfs. Or Vargeist, whatever they are. The flying bat things. 113 on those guys. Jesus Christ. He certainly, like, pulled his weight, didn't he? Did I get 113 on anything? No. Also, I lost a unit of zombies. Didn't lose any spears, so. Quest complete. Woohoo! Dominate captives.
Swifter than death.
Unlocked another unit of renown, that's cool. Quest successful, we got the gold sigil sword. Okay.
Bow!
Bow! We want that for the extra movement range. Weapon, gold sigil sword, there we go. And he's got that for magic resistance, the staff for domination. Cool. Gravedigger, raise dead cost. Cool. and we'll pop him back into Warden. And we need 6 turns to get enough growth, it appears. And then, oh, what's this guy? Ah, so by doing that quest battle, we just unlocked a necromancer. So I want him in that army. The reason why I want him in Vlad's army is these guys are absolutely amazing at AoE healing. So if I actually rank this guy up, so if I have a look at there, we can go with Invocation of Nehek and then go for the Curse of the Undead. Then we can go for Master of the Undead for even more hit points. And what's this? Well, we can get him a corpse mount, a corpse cart. Does a corpse cart come with all the benefits though? Or is it just... Because if it comes with the corpse, the extra benefits, and that's extra heals as well, which would be even better. And then obviously we've got down here, we've got spoiler, which is minus income from enemy buildings. Where is it? Extra income from our buildings, which would be good. Does he have any healing down here? Doesn't look like it. That must be the vampires that I'm thinking of then. So end turn here. And we are rolling into turn 6, I believe. Oh, you've got to be kidding. He's on ambush. He's on ambush, isn't he? Okay, mission issued. In battle, eliminate a lord belonging to any of the following. So, to them. Wait, so if we... Oh, belonging to the enemies of them. Tempelhof. Okay, turns to complete. The treasurer. Which is... extra income, which is good. Is it income? Yes. And we get extra diplomatic relations. So he pretty much ambushed here, didn't he? I've never played an ambush before, as in like I'm being ambushed. How are my forces looking? He did have a big stack, didn't he? I can add a couple more zombies to the force.
Unstoppable.
And then just like bait him out. Here we go. Come at me. Yeah. dear. Silver 1 on the Blood Knights now. Kinda cool. Kinda cool. So he's got a rubbish force really. Even if he surrounds me, I'm still... we might as well gamble because more power is always good. And it pays. We're in group 1. You guys in group 2. You guys... He doesn't have anything really that I need to worry about when it comes to cavalry. Oh, typical. Bloody typical. There, go. Reform. There is... Oh, that's out. Toggle speed. Go, go, go. Get into formation. Okay, Blood Knights. I want you to go over there. Okay, so it looks like we're going to crash into the center, so let's get those guys helping. those in the centre there, you guys push out. You guys get into the flank, you push into their behind. You guys move round, you push into the back, get the birdies over the top. Get my lord into the mix. You can step back a bit. You can throw up your unit there. Stuck in as well. Look nice. You get into the corpse carts. Blood knights will absolutely wreck those zombies. These guys are winning that fight. You get in. Blood knights pull out again, please.
Vlad Von Carstein!
Vlad, I need you for this, buddy. Need you over there.
The summoning begins!
You guys. Stuck in there. Blood Knight's one. Looks like we're losing quite a few actually. Throw the heal there. You can't do anything like it. Power. I didn't realize we had enough scouting units over here. Make sure we got everything. Yeah, we do. You're actually losing quite a bit, aren't you? So you need to pull you back out. Well, but that's out a sec.
Yes! By Van Hell!
Rest in there as well, kill off their leader. Okay, so over here we have a unit has been wiped out. That must have been the bats, yeah. So that necromancer was able to kill the bats, but I don't think he's gonna live much longer with a bomb because they put knives on him. There you go, down. So let's pull the blood knife out of the bomb because it's gonna handle him. There he goes. Get them into there, you guys. Out again. I think. Yeah, they are. They're probably now. They're gone. There we go. How dare you even think about 100 kills? Jesus Christ. They don't half rack up some kills. Like, a lot. I'm gonna have to make an army based on those. Kinda like what he's done, but with less zombies. Dominate again. And then if we can chase him down. I want to kill him off. And I want to dominate again. The reason I'm dominating is you actually unlock the Legendary Lord by dominating Helmnung Ghost or something like that, I believe his name is. But yeah, one of the new guys you actually unlock him by treasure. Got the Forbidden Rod ability. Greatly improves power recharge rate. Greatly increases power reserves. Chance your opponent resists damage. Causes damage to self. Okay. Okie dokie. Rank ups, we want the relentless dead. Did you get a rank up? Yes you did, you want that. So it's more AoE healing. And take a look. What we got? We got chance of wounding, wounding aggressors, and that's it. But yeah, as I was saying, Helm of Gorse, you have a look, see? Dominate 10 sets of captives. I believe I've dominated 3 now. Because I dominated that battle here, and then 2 here. So, yeah.
The world.
Hopefully.
In blood.
We're looking pretty decent. And we've got corpse pile there, which is pretty good as well. Province instability, yeah. How many more turns? 5 more. We don't need turns until I can have enough growth. I really should start actually building the growth buildings earlier on to try and get things rolling around. It would have been a lot better if they didn't actually charge out and take out Eshin as well. I really did need that to upgrade. I mean, at least we've got more income now and more public order, which is pretty good. 2 turns anyway, we'll have the next research done, so that'll be even more income and more growth, and then we'll start going into Bloody's Power for even more growth. Should we actually recruit another army? I don't think I need another army to take them on. So I think I should just be able to charge straight in there with this particular force. I mean, I could actually raise some skellies. Raise some skellies. And we'll have the doggies of renown as well.
Bow before me.
Bow before me. And then we'll go and wreck some face.
Shed their blood!
Yeah. So we've pretty much got these guys in the bag. I want some siege towers though, so we'll wait.
No mercy!
We'll wait 3 turns before we could do that. So that'd be cool, keep them pinned. We've got the fort here to deal with, and then we've got to do with Schwarzenhafen. I think that's how you say it. Schwarzenhafen. Yes, yeah, Schwarzenhafen. No, I can't. It's German. Or at least it sounds German to me. So yeah, gonna kill Tempelhof. Now we've got them under siege. The only way they can really help is to build a stack here and send it. We need a couple of turns, really. I could make another lord, but I kind of want to go... Oh, we ain't got a ghoul king anyway, so we'll wait a few turns, because I want a ghoul king, and I want to start doing, like, making ghoul armies, which I think would be kind of cool. To have, like, an army of ghouls and crypt horrors and terrorgeists and stuff like that. Some varghulfs. What would be cool if you could have like some foot vampires. So you know you got the Blood Knights, so instead of being on cavalry like Blood Knights on foot, and then just have an army of just vampires, that would be amazing. I wonder if there's a mod or something you can get that would allow you to do that. That'd be pretty sick. So we're waiting 2 more turns there, aren't we? Let's have a look. Can we recruit a lord? Yes we can. What's he got? Honourable. Plus 6 leadership, that's not too bad if I recruit him here. What can you raise, buddy? You can raise a few zombies to help out. Don't really want zombies.
Tremble, mortal.
Yeah, I don't want skellies. I want him to be, like, specific. So what I'll do is I'll wait a turn and I'll bring him over here and then try and rank him up in the fight. We need 3 more turns. 1 more turn for the thing. I don't want to waste my public surplus. Oh, we've got orcs in our land.
Speak
what? Stirland?
And pray to thy
no one expects the Stirland. Did you just see that? Look at this. Go away. Stirland, the sneaky fox. They just come in and took over... Free Company Militia. That's that new unit, isn't it? Need to... Ooh, we're going to have some fun taking on them. So I want to win that battle so I can actually get in there and take them on. And we want Bloody's Power, don't we? In terms of that.
From the tombs.
Still can't summon any ghouls, which isn't too good. We'll move you up. So Tempelhof, that's why they're suing for peace, because they actually went to war with Stirland. I can't believe these gits have actually like pushed into our land. They got pistoliers, free company militia, loads of spears, like blooming loads of spears.
Strigoi,
how dare you come into our lands? I am so gonna ruin your face.
All shall perish.
One more turn, and then we can siege that off. Get
death
that dealt with.
And destruction.
Death and destruction. Actually,
massacre them.
Would that still take one turn? I could do with a battering ram. No, it's only gonna take two. So we'll continue.
The world will be mine.
And then we'll charge in there and slaughter that off. Two more turns, and then we can upgrade Castle Drakenhof. I actually kind of tempted to destroy the brazier there, because I don't have enough slots at this stage of the campaign to actually afford it, so to speak. So I might destroy it.
Strategic overview can be useful.
Because once I upgrade this to 2, I'm going to be wanting to actually like build the defiled crane so I can actually get the banshees and the crypt horrors, but also I want the ancient armory so I can actually start getting grave guards, which would be good, like really really good. So I think I'm gonna have to sack that off. And here we go. We won't auto-resolve. They are going to feel...
Well, to be honest, they gave it a good run, didn't they? They did try. I mean, they attacked Eshin twice. You fuckers.
So irritating, the way that they just show up and out of nowhere. Like, that massive stack that he had. I mean, yeah, it was only zombies and whatnot, but Jesus Christ, it just shows up out of nowhere. And wrecks my face. Ooh, 20. Yeah, we'll take that. Start the fire. I like how my Ghoul King is just literally going to run in there all on his one. Like a boss. Okay, so if I do this. Put them over there. So that's group 1. Your group 2. Put group 2's towers here, along with, what should we send? We'll send you guys over there. You guys can go in with these towers, I suppose. Zombies. Yeah, they'll just stand in a line and just charge the wall, really. Have you got ladders, zombies? Yeah, did you? Oh my days. I do love how silly it is at times. Put those there. What are these guys? Scout warriors. And the leaders. Pop you there, the Vargulfs. Pop you with the dogs and everything. Star battle. They're gonna get up. And if we grab all of these, and we'll get ourselves up. You two attack the wall. Get up the wall. And if we push these guys forward, there are any zombies, may as well get them. Wow, look at this city. So I've only just noticed, look. Oh, it's a, oh wow. This looks fantastic.
Send troops to capture the enemy defenses, Commander. They'll be turned to our service.
Okay. Look at this. Graveyards, chapels. Excuse me. That looks absolutely fantastic. It's like a proper fantasy city. That was amazing.
exactly what I'd expect to see when you like coming into a vampire like stronghold. Squig of Gorking. You break the wall. And then over here we've still got all our forces walking. Speed up guys, let's go. Ladders have docked the walls. So let's have a look what's going on in this bit then. The Vargeist, rather, wrecking face, as to be expected, since there are only zombies over here. Let's push them in. How are we doing on the actual gate? 7%. I use that to increase melee attack. They too can just keep bashing the gate. Those are going to walk up, those are going to walk up there. There's going up as well.
With haste!
So those guys are all going up the wall. Do you know what this reminds me of? This reminds me of like Jason and the Argonauts. Check this guy, he hasn't even got a head. Oh, he's dead, no wonder. Didn't even know what he's doing. Look at the detail in this place. Insane. Alright, you guys. May as well get stuck in there as well. You guys may as well get stuck in there as well. We hold this section of the wall, so you guys can start making your way to the center. Over here you can start killing those, and in the middle here you can start killing those. Really, they've only got zombies to hold the place. I want to break that open because I need to get my blood knife in there. Well, this is looking like a pretty easy siege, to be fair. Oh, well, at least we get to go and take on Stirland after, don't we? Come on. We've got no binding left, it should be gone by now. So send those guys against those. Let's try and... These zombies, are they walking or are they running? What else are they doing? They need to pick up the pace.
No,
where are you going? Stop. Break the gate down.
Vlad Von Carstein!
Oh god, Vlad went on the wall. God damn it. That's no good. And my Vargeist are getting their asses handed to them. So let's pull them out. Over here, you guys need to go around. Is ever gonna die. Okay. Let's pull these guys out and send them to the square. Those guys can't attack the wall. It's any serious, is it? It looks like the majority of their force are here. There are some in the center, like some bats. And there is like someone else. I gotta get those out of there, otherwise they're gonna die. I pull them this way. Can I get a heal on them in time? And I do too. So I really don't want to lose those guys. Guys, rather. God damn it. Blowing bats, man. You missed Casa. Get those in the center. This whole siege thing, it's like just cluster fucks on the wall, really, isn't it? I mean, if the gate was open, it would have been better. I think from now on, I'm going to build battering rams as well, so I can actually get gates down. I mean, that's a 90 down. 91.
Vlad Von Carstein!
So Vlad can pretty much solo all this now, though. Oh, they're all crumbling now. Every swing. Wonder who Bloody's covered in. Boots him over. Love it. So how are we going in the centre there? With this Ghoul King. Is that like a werewolf type of deal, isn't it?
Every time we swing, let's check him go.
Oh, he's down. Okay, cool. That was anticlimactic. I was expecting him to last a little bit longer than that. Fair enough. He got 13 kills. Vlad got 77. 114 before I lost my Var, guys. No. Please resurrect. Really don't want to lose those guys. Come on, you know you want to give me them back. You know you do. Ah, oh, got him back. Thank God for that. They didn't raise again. Hell yes. Whew, I was worried then. Yeah, we'll keep him here so he can, like, recover.
I approve.
I approve. Rutter Von Carstein has perished in battle. Yeah. Family destroyed Temple Hearth. Goodbye, farewell, don't come back. And what can we build here? We will go with... Actually, we'll learn our lesson and we'll go with growth. Can't believe stones right there. Then we got the dwarves and orcs and... Yeah, all sorts going on all over the shop. Okay, so Sterland, what I want to know what these three are. That's obviously a hero. But what are the other two? I mean, we've got three group, three company militia. They're the new units, aren't they? I have no idea how they function.
Cower before me.
Enemy hero chance. I want to go with quick blood. This guy didn't actually get anything. End of turn then. So turn 12, not doing too bad. We've taken Castle Temple Half and taken out the faction of Temple Half, which is good. We need to deal with Sterland because they have just pushed into our lands and we don't want that happening at all.
Your prestige grows.
That's good. So that's another...
News of your conquest spreads far and wide.
Quest issue.
You're developing...
Six. And... King of the Ghouls. We want that and that. There we go. Look how much money we got.
I am Vlad.
I love how quickly everything regenerates. I mean, by the time all this is regenerated, watch what the rankings do. So let's have a look at the Var guys, for example. They're on 2 rank, and the Blood Knights are on 2 as well. So we're not really going to be doing much this turn, particularly. I want to pull him back eventually to get something from there, but I do want to actually heal up a tad before we push in again. We'll add another unit of skellies to the army. So yeah, take note, that and that.
Bow!
Oh yeah, this is my necromancer. We'll go raise dead. Yeah, we'll go raise dead. End of turn. Because we just want the Vargeist and everything to heal up, so that's pretty much what we're waiting for. But not only that, what it actually pays us to wait, because the longer we wait, we actually get more rankings, which is absolutely fantastic. I mean, look. If you have a look at the experience, it was empty. Now it's like a third. And that's pretty full, so they're going to be silver free. before they'll both be silver three when we take on Stirling, which will be next turn probably, because I want them Vargas at full health. And yeah, so pretty much burn another turn, and then we'll push. And after we've taken on Stirling, I believe that'll be a good place to end this little bit of Let's Play. Okay, so we've got one more turn until that kicks in, which is good.
I am invincible.
Okay. We should put that to the test. So that'll be the thing that we'll get next then. I do need to get that now though. Now that we've actually got surplus to spend, we need to get that up to level 3, or 2 rather, so we can actually get the Graveguard.
What?
And over here. Silver. Silver, it should be silver 3 now. Well, they're silver 3. we need another turn for full health. Take on this. Yeah, we'll wait one more turn. I want them to be on full health before we take them on. I don't want to be going in there without them being anything but at their best. So, rotate all the way around. That should actually activate a corpse pile though as well after we attack. I can't believe the arrogance of Stirling pushing into our
unstoppable.
Lands. We are unstoppable. We'll add another group of zombies to the army.
King of Darkness.
King of Darkness.
I am unstoppable.
Declare war. How dare you enter our lands?
Death and destruction. Annihilate them.
Ooh. It's equal. I don't believe it should be. Well, it's more to them. I mean, they've got a lot of spears, and we've got a lot of everything else, and we've got this guy. No, it's not equal. You don't understand the power of Vlad von Carstein. And we're literally going to deploy in their face as well, so their reinforcements ain't going to help them at all. And we've got 2 units of renown, we've got the Silver 3 Blood Knights, we've got... Yeah, we got this. We've got this. I'm convincing myself that I'm not going to lose. God, I hope I don't lose. Okay, we are going to gamble because firepower is rubbish. Hey, gambling pays. Gambling pays well. So, front line of Zibbies. Followed by... Skelly Bobs. And we'll put you there, you on the front line. Spear unit there, the spear unit here. Doggies on the back, Vargulfs on the back, you on the flank. Start a battle. And push. If we can get them before their reinforcements arrive, that will be good.
knight to spears.
That's close. I don't know how the balance of power of doing in this. You dare shoot me? Look at him go! Jesus! Good night, so pull back out again, guys. Yeah, that's good.
Vlad Von Carstein! Darkness reigns!
Undead
knight! With haste! Knight, the battle!
I actually don't know how this is doing. It doesn't look good. Where's my... Oh, he looks like he's dead. Stop right there, good night. Get them stuck back in there again. I think the necromancer's dead. Good, actually. I don't think I'm going to win this one. Lost that flank. Those pistoliers are coming back. We need to get the dogs over here, don't we? Chase those down. I don't want to lose the blood knights. So if we can keep the blood knights attacking their missile troops.
Vlad Von Carstein!
Just lost the bargle. Throw it on the blood knights then. So that's gonna shatter them. Lord. Come on, you can have him.
That's it. Run. Do exactly as he said. Run away. I'm having a hard time if you don't. Come on. Get him. How's Vlad doing?
All shall bow before me.
Those guys aren't doing too well down there. Those guys aren't doing too well over there, but that's got the renown unit in it as well. Where are my dogs? Here they come. Chase down those. Over here. Broken. We can keep him that way. Really want to kill him. Come on, you can have him. Come on, Blood Knights, you gotta do it.
Sigmar demands blood.
Okay, we lost that unit. The renown unit is still hanging in there. The Blood Knights are still hanging in there. Those guys are chasing off those guys. Have you killed him yet? Just kill him, damn it. 256, you need to do anything to mine. See if we can get another charge on him, see if that'll help. I'm not worried about Vlad. Kill him. Charge into them instead. Vlad will pretty much solo everything there on his own. Well, solo everything on his own. Yeah, good English there, Kev. And get into them. They broke pretty much instantly. Okay, so what I've got left is my fast stuff. Break their morale.
Vlad Von Carstein.
No, I need you. Kill that guy that just came back. Where are my dogs?
No one can stop.
Okay, so I got 3 units to kill all of that.
Vlad Von Carstein.
Can't cast anything for them with 6.
What do you want? All shall suffer.
How do you add 200 health? Keep them moving because I don't want them getting locked down.
This world is mine. Lord of the Dead. My bad health.
Let's get them into them.
Bow before me.
Come on. Go, go, go. Get my dogs. Into the back of those guys, please. We can kill the Lord. Come on. Come on, you can have him. Get him. Get him. Come on.
Weapons out, lads!
There you go.
Time for fighting!
Is he dead? Is he? Yes!
Vlad Von Carstein.
Okay, so that's just... might have just won me the game. Barely.
Kneel before your master.
Right, now these dogs and the Blood Knight should be able to mop everything else, so that's broke them. I suck at this game so bad. Vlad, 117 kills. Jesus Christ. 151 for those. I lost my Vargas, obviously. Yeah. 82 kills for those. 45.
Skeletons really ain't that strong, are they? I need some Graveguard. Pyrrhic victory. Okay.
I want their souls!
I didn't get my Vargeist back. Sucks a bit.
Shed their blood!
What do we expect? Killed in battle. Gust and Von Carstein. So I lost my Ghoul King, and we can actually get the Ghouls of Renown as well, which would be pretty cool. Go over here. We need one more turn, two more turns. Can we recruit another Ghoul King? Military heritage. We'll get that one. You want some of those. Recruit. And you also want one of those and one of those. So we can actually start getting his army together now. May as well upgrade that. We don't need that there, so we'll sack it off. I can't believe Stirland actually pushed in on us. Or into the Vampire Lands at least, anyway. So, yeah, that is where we'll leave it, guys. So thanks ever so much for tuning in. If you like what you see, as always, please subscribe. Yeah, give us a like as well. And if you think you know anyone else that might enjoy this series, why not share? So, until next time, thanks very much for watching, and have a nice day.